Good morning, student. There is another part of chapter number 1, Indian economics. We have done up to foreign trade. Now we'll continue it with the demographic conditions. Now in the demographic conditions, what was that? Firstly, there was high birth rate and high death rate in India at the time of independence. Secondly, infant mortality rate was also high. Infant mortality rate means the newborn babies which are up to 1 year, from 1 month to 1 year, are considered in infant mortality rate. Okay, the death of babies under 1 year. Then your literacy rate was very low, that is 16%, and especially in girls, female literacy rate was approximately below 7%. Next one is your life expectancy rate was approximately 44 years as compared to today's life. In today we are we have expectancy rate up to 60, 65, 70, but at that time it was approximately 32 to 44 years at max. Next one is poor health facility. There were very poor health facilities. They don't have any primary healthcare facilities also. The facilities which were provided to them were basically belong to big landlords or some Britishers only. They were not allowed to go over there at big hospitals to treat themselves. Next one is widespread poverty. Because of the commercialization of crops, as malnutrition was also increasing, but because the wealth was all drained by the Britishers only, so because of that, poverty was increasing day by day. Next one is your occupational structure during British rule. Now what about the occupational structure? In occupational structure, first one is 70% of the people were engaged in agriculture, 10% were engaged in mostly manufacturing, and 20% were approximately in service center. So because of the large strength in agriculture, there was very much problems in secondary as well as tertiary sector. There was very much on a very big scale, there was a decline in workforce in agricultural sector. Basically, in Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Kerala, Karnataka, Maharashtra and West Bengal, in these places, there were drastic changes and very low rate of workforce in agricultural sector. Whereas, there was rise in agricultural sector workforce in Orissa, Rajasthan and Punjab. Next one is your infrastructure. In infrastructure, what was given? Firstly, roads were built. Now, why roads were built? Roads were built for basically armies and shifting the raw materials. Secondly, railway was introduced in 1850, which was used to enhance the commercialization of Indian agriculture. Now, what does it mean? It means that when the railways were introduced, because of that, marketing of agriculture was easy. And they can supply their goods from one place to another place at very ease. Next one is air and water transport were also introduced. And lastly, communication was made easy through post and telegraph. Postal services was available for everyone at that time. But particular, it was controlled by the Britishers only. Next one is your positive contribution of British rule. Now, how British rule has positively affected our India? At the eve of independence, we were not self-sufficient because of the lack of agricultural facilities, but due to British rule, they provided us with so many technology that we were self-sufficient in food grain production. Because after British rule, we shifted from commercialization of crop to food crop again. The next one is transportation facilities were excellent. Because of them, we were introduced to roads, railways and waterways, airways, etc. Next one is check on famines. Due to British rule, now Britishers were very keen to get the profit out of India. So, time to time, they go places to places and check whether there are famines or not famines, there are the facilities provided to the farmers or not. Not because they want to care for farmers, but because they want to care for themselves. Next one is shift to monetary economy from barter economy. They introduced monetary system. They introduced money. Because of that, we shifted from barter trade, that is goods in exchange of goods, to exchange of money. Last one is effective administrative setup. Now, because of Britishers, we were introduced to an administrative system. They told us how to organize a meeting, how to manage any area, or how to organize something. So, because of them, our administrative skills were increased. That was all about your chapter. Here your chapter ends. Thank you.